Godzilla's a punk. It's official that Godzilla's a punk. Bam! Welcome to Midwest Miniature Guys, official Monday night mini Monday stream. Hello, everybody. How you doing? So we streamed last night. Last night was our 2-year anniversary on Twitch, and we finished up the Pathfinder Red Dragon. Tonight, we're just chatting. We're going to be painting some minis, hopefully getting some finished up, and yeah, we'll see how the night goes. So, anyway, let's go ahead and get started. Hello, hello. So, I've been working on this one for a while. This is the one that I was trying to print myself, and out of 3 tries, it wasn't working. So, I had my friend Peter from Daedalus Studios print it for me. It's better. Mine had a bunch of stuff still coming off here, and this was not even... It was even more deformed than this one is. This one you can actually tell he's wearing like a glove. But we got a few things that were left up that we're going to get finished on this guy. We've got to do the bone handle of the sword and the horn, and the design on his tunic. We're going to clean up the shield rim a little bit, and then we got to do the base. We need to paint his eyes and his beard, and finish up the gloves. So, yeah, let's go ahead and get started on these here, shall we? What are we doing? We got one viewer tonight, everybody. Hey, everybody. How's it going? Hey, now I got 2 windows. I can do 2 things at the same time. Yay! Let's see. Where did I stop off with this guy? I was done with the blue. And yeah, that's right. We're going to move on to the gloves real quick. The gloves I did in russet brown, so I'm going to quick hit it with some harvest brown and some orange brown. The blue is what I wanted to stick out the most, because that's it's the customer's favorite color. At least that's what his wife told me. So this is supposed to be a Christmas present. He's currently out of town right now, and so they aren't doing Christmas yet. So I got some time to get this done and really make it look nice. Clear out my bottles here. And we had a great stream last night. We streamed from 8 to midnight last night. That's probably my longest stream. I think it was 4 hours long, which is quite a lot for me, because normally I only stream for a couple hours. But 4 hours, that was a good long time. That was fun, though. Definitely getting down into the nitty gritty of mini painting last night, though, because I was showing people how to dry brush and paint eyes and all sorts of fun stuff. So, yeah, see, painting eyes here. Everybody see, we're doing alright. It's still a little fuzzy. Why is it fuzzy? Nope, that didn't help any. There we go. That way, if I can hold it here, y'all should be able to see what I'm doing. here so I'm nice and close, and move that. Oh, it's way too bright. Taking this lovely harvest brown. I had a chunk that was on my brush there. If you're hearing something in the background, it's my little heater because it is cold down here. In the basement studio. So I am in Minnesota. Okay, there's that glove. I'm gonna go over here and the thumb. Alright, that is that. Can I use this for anything else? There's a flick of that. Grab this autumn brown here, harvest brown, whatever it's called, orange brown. And with this, we're just going to hit the knuckles, so I'm just going to do a little dot there. Alright, and that color is done. I'm done with that. However, I've got way too much of that color all over the place, so I want to put it on her bow. Yeah, I grabbed a different mini. This is a Ranger mini from Bones. From Reaper minis. I hate leaving this amount of paint on my palette. I just got way too much out. Actually, let's put this on her quiver. See, I used some contrast paint to kind of pick out areas, see where I want to put stuff. And now I'm going to go in and add some midtones and some highlights. Maybe a couple of scratches here. Just like that. So I'm just trying to get the camera right for you guys. There. Quiver is done. I'll do the handle to her dagger here. That's not going to need much. So, handle to her dagger. Much I can do with this guy yet. What about this guy? This guy, I could do his legs in this. Make him look like he's got some brown tights. That's a good call. So I'm going to take a little bit of this harvest brown and I'm going to do the leaves on his armor here. Game Master's Vault. Hello, hola nerds, what's happening? The whole lot's still working, just not very hard. Yeah, I hear you. I had today off from the day job, so I will be going, both my wife and I will be going back tomorrow. And I'm not looking forward to it. But what are you gonna do? Unfortunately, unlike some folks, I know some folks that are professional miniature painters. This is what they do for a living. And unfortunately, I am not to that point yet where I could just hang it all up and go, well, I'm just going to do this from now on. Maybe when I retire, I can do this. Another 25 years. Tonight we're just painting minis that are on the paint desk. I thought I was going to try and do the Black Dwarf, but I was working on it a little bit. I was looking at it and was trying to figure out how I wanted to do it. And I think I'm not going to do him on stream. I'm just going to, because he's a commission, I think I just want to get him done. That's what we're doing for his leather armor. Kind of creating this autumnal feel for the pauldrons in his little thing there. Well, what I'm working on right now is for my own table, or possibly to sell at Con of the North this year in February. But yeah, I do take on commissions. The Marvel Crisis Protocol stuff that I'm painting is for my friend Patrick. And then I've got some 3D printed dice towers I've got to paint for Giant Turtle Creations. Another guy just sent me 5 minis that he wants to pick up at Con of the North, so I got a couple months, less than 2 months, to get those done. And then the Hero Forge one that I have, this guy here, is a Christmas present for a client's husband. So, pretty sure you saw me at Con of the North 1 year. It's been years since I've been up there, though. Yeah, I've been going there now for, this will be my 11th year. Of course, I took 2021 off because they did it virtually and hard to paint minis and get commissions and sell minis virtually at a convention. So that would have been my 11th year. I was there in 2020. Right before everything shut down. Which sucked. Yeah, Con of the North has been going on for like 30 years now or something like that. You know, I think it was either 2019 or whenever they did their big 50th anniversary, and I saw a video that was shot down at from a balcony of the opening of the vendors hall, and there was a ton of people milling about, and then the hall doors opened, and it was just this wave of people walking in. And I started getting vertigo and like a little motion sickness because it was just this wave after wave of people. I'm like, ooh, that's a lot. I don't think I could do that. I've been to Gary Con, I've been to, of course, Con of the North because I vendor there. But thought about going to Gen Con and I saw that video and went, maybe not. Maybe I won't go. Kim and I went to Gary Con last year. And then this year we're planning on going to a Gamehole Con in Madison. That's in October. October or November. I think it's October or November of this year. And that reminds me, I should try and see. I need to look up and find out how much convergence is for a vendor table, even if it's just a little one. My buddy Charles Erbach has been trying to talk me into that and doing that. And he's been trying to talk me into put something in the art display room. Which I'm like, that would be interesting to put a miniature into the artist room. Find a con in a warm place. That would be like North Texas Con. North Texas RPG Con. That's the thing, is like most conventions start. I think the earliest I think is February, and then it's Gary Con, and then it's North Texas RPG Con, and then you got Gen Con. There's a couple other smaller cons too. I don't have an LLC, but I am set up with in Minnesota for yeah, Reaper Con is in Denton, Texas, at their one of their hotels or convention centers. I wouldn't mind. I would love to do Reaper Con. That would be a ton of fun. To actually just go, not be a vendor or anything, because you know, whatever. But that would be a ton of fun to go there and actually meet some of my friends that I know. But yeah, no, I am set up with a business. ID for tax purposes, so I can write off Con of the North and stuff like that. see if I can get that little leaf back there. There we go. I think it'd be fun to go to Origins. That might be kind of cool to do. Again, not as a vendor, but just as a patron. So there's our kind of harvesty brown look on his armor. I'm not done yet. I'm gonna have to get in there and I gotta do the borders and the insides and stuff like that. But I'm not sure what I want to do yet for that. I might do a paler brown. I might go in and do some bronze maybe. Bronze. So many things to deduct for businesses, like even the mini you're painting now for your own personal use, you can deduct because it's entertainment, education on your Twitch channel, brushes, paints, minis, camera equipment, internet costs, software, all adds up. Oh yeah. Well aware. Edges here. All right, now we'll get back to this guy here. Grab just a little bit. Just barely a brushful of this skeletal horde. Yeah, the 50th was 2019, wasn't it? 69,999 other nerds converged on Indianapolis. Holy cow. Yeah, no thanks. Nope, nope, nope. Alright, so I don't know if who all was watching last night, but I used this same recipe for gold as I did on the dragon's belly. So it's chestnut gold, palomino gold, buckskin pale, and maybe some white. It depends on. Well, 65,000 more people than I needed to be around. Yeah, that's a lot of people, man. Holy cow. Got my colors out. Let's see if my hands will let me do this today. I was doing pretty good. I got the dragon painted on his shield. Oh, I've got a ton of different paint brands. I've got Reaper and Vallejo, Citadel, Army Painter, Pro Acryl, AK Interactive. I've got a ton of different paint brands. It really depends on what I'm going with. What colors I'm looking for, what effects I want to do. I was quite a bit of Reaper fanboy there for a while because I was just painting with Walmart craft paints, but I will say that Citadel, I think, has the best washes, and I think that Army Painter has the nice tones. I really like those. AK Interactive and Vallejo have great colors for your more historical painting, especially when it comes to war games and such. So all of them have their own, one unique properties and pros and cons. Trying to find all the little details that are on his tunic here. They're so tiny. Oh yeah, some of those European painters are stunning. Absolutely stunning. Those guys that are doing the historical stuff with the tapestries and the horse blankets and the livery of certain, like they do their research and find out the livery of certain houses and things like that, of nobles, and that's just crazy talk, man. I've seen it. I don't know how they do it. I've watched them paint. And I went and found videos of how these guys are doing it. And it's, their brushes are dirtier than mine. Like, they just look like they're just caked in paint. But they're in there just doing, like, these super intricate designs and stuff like that. I'm like, come on. Here I am just trying to highlight a belt here. A design on this tunic. I just want to highlight this design. They're out there literally painting full scenes on frickin' horse blankets. Don't get me wrong, it is beautiful, beautiful work. Just that I'm not that talented. I suppose I could be. If I really sat down and practiced, I could probably get to that level, but I would much rather paint for gamers and give them a really cool looking mini for gaming purposes than something that they can just throw on their mantle and just look at it. Yeah, the old one hair brush, yep. Exactly. He's got some like little designs, got little jewels or something that's on his tunic here. I don't know exactly what color I want to do those yet. Your minis are table ready if you're squinting. Yeah, that's the main thing. And that's what I was trying to tell Depopulation last night, is that just have fun with it. You don't have to, you know, be super intricate if you don't want to, especially if you're painting Skaven or anything like that. Just have fun. Painting minis should be fun. Either that, if it wasn't fun, I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't be down here every night painting. You know, I'd be upstairs reading or just sitting on the couch, watching TV, which is horrible lately. Seriously, the only TV that I watch is like some Netflix stuff and some stuff on Disney Plus. That's it. Other than that, I would rather come down here, paint, and maybe watch some of my friends that are on Twitch. Watch them do some role-playing or some modeling or painting or something. You've got a friend who is 3D printing and painting the entire monster manual? Holy cow. Yeah, his painting is getting better very quickly. Yeah, that's because he's painting 800 monsters. There's a client of mine that wants me to, that he and I may try and set up a paint night where I come over to his house and teach him and his friends how to paint. So that would be fun. He's like, I'll We'll pay you, and then we'll also pay you in scotch. I'm like, well, that's great. I don't mind a thing of scotch, but I won't be drinking while I'm painting. 400 minis in the last couple of years. That's a good start. There were a few years where I felt like I did about 400 minis that entire year. Because I was doing armies and stuff like that for clients. I try not to do that anymore. I try to only do like, I don't know, 5 or 6 minis in a batch if I can. Otherwise, I just get a little burnt out. Then I know that I gotta take a break and, you know, go play a video game or something, or read a book. Love to get back into streaming on a schedule to force myself to paint so many unpainted minis. You know, I mean, that's kind of one of the reasons why I wanted to do it, is that, you know, it's forced me to sit down and work on the stuff that I needed to work on. But I also wanted to be able to chat with other folks about miniature painting and teach different techniques and stuff, because I didn't have that when I was getting into painting. Like, YouTube was new. Or non-existing. I don't even know if YouTube was around yet. Maybe it was. And I didn't know anybody in the miniature painting communities at that time. So, I had just moved over to Minnesota. Didn't know anybody. I remember when Miniature Mentor came out with some painting DVDs, how to paint white, how to paint black, how to paint scan, how to paint non-metallic metal. And my mother-in-law got me those for Christmas one year. So I would sit down here and watch those while I try to paint. That's how I got good at doing skin and better at painting black. There's a ton of stuff that you can do for painting black. Yeah, I got the Jessica. I don't. Did I get Jessica Rich? No, I got the Jen Haley DVD that Dark Sword put out. And that was really good. I enjoyed watching her paint. She's one of my favorite painters. Jessica Rich is really good, too. I don't know if they still have them, but the source used to have James Wapples DVDs in there. Now, like, he doesn't paint with acrylics anymore. He just does oil, so those DVDs are kind of obsolete to what he is doing now. Of course, everything that he does is, you know, he'll paint on Twitch, but then he also has his Patreon and stuff like that. And how crazy is it that people have, like, Patreons now? Like, for just a couple, you know, a couple of bucks or whatever a month, you can support an artist out there. You know, oh, we're gonna get you this cool, you know, subscription, basically. You spent so much on minis, paints, hot wire cutter, static grass applicator, two airbrushes, and bins upon bins of crappy stuff. I gotta start using it all. Yep. Yep, get in there, man. Start using it. Might as well. You ever want to do a paint along, let me know. We'll grab the same mini and we'll paint along with you. I did that last year, I think it was. Well, yeah, and for me, like, I can't afford to do a Patreon or anything like that, but, you know, support anybody that way. But I just think, like, you know, when artists had patrons, it was a noble family or a merchant family or something like that. Like, they would pay you a stipend to paint this painting, and you know they knew it was going to take like a couple of months or something like that for you to do it. And now it's almost like semi-instant gratification to an extent. I'm going to hop on this Patreon and I'm going to get all these videos that this guy's already put out, and I'll get them for like, I get all this content and for $5 a month, you know, or however much you want to, whatever their tiers are. And now the artist is, you know, telling you how much his stuff is going to be rather than just going, oh yeah, I'll take whatever, because I'm an artist. Well, it's like, no, I'm an artist. Pay me this. Like, I was contacted to do a couple of commissions last week. And I gave them my price, and they were like, really, that much? I'm like, yeah. Oh, well, maybe I should just do it myself. I'm like, you probably should if you're going to balk at, you know, my measly little prices. Right, and that's another reason why I don't do the whole Patreon thing. It's like, what would I give out as a gift? I don't know. I know that James does, you know, his gifts to his patrons or whatever, or like, you know, Patreon exclusive video or something like that, but I don't have anything that exclusive that I could do. Cause that's the thing, is like, if you subscribe to a Patreon of mine and I said, oh, okay, your exclusive gift is one painted miniature per month for at the highest level. Well, now I'm just painting Patreon minis rather than doing my stuff or any other commission work. Because now I've got to get out, say, 100 minis in a month. That ain't gonna happen. It's just not. I don't work like that. Okay, I think I'm just gonna leave it there. I think that looks good. Oh, there's absolutely a ton of information here. For me, it's writing it. Like, I would need a script. I would do like a half an hour video of how to paint brown leather or something like that, or something silly. But see, that's the thing, that like there's a ton of techniques out there that once you know how to do them, you can apply that technique on every piece on the mini. Especially if it's just layering. So like what I did just on the tunic borders. There we go. Just on the tunic borders, I mean, that's just layering. It's nothing special. It kind of looks like non-metallic metal, but it's not. It's just, if you wanted to go non-metallic metal on something like that, then you'd be, doing another wash, or you'd be adding in some white to get the gleam in, and you find out where your light source is coming from, so you know where you're putting it. Let's see, speaking of that, let's try and do those a little. You know what? I don't normally use the folk art, but this is blue metallic. And since this guy, his favorite color is blue, I'm gonna make those little jewels in his tunic here. I'm just gonna get a little blue metallic. You don't get what, Game Master? You should, since you're there in the Invergrove Heights area, you should come up to our February 4th gig at the Dubliner in St. Paul. I think you'd have a blast. You have some bugs that you've started. I want to paint parts black and cover with Folk Arts color shift paint so they have a beetle-like character. That'd be cool. Absolutely. So there's the little jewels in his tunic. That worked out well. Boom. Those are done. Yeah, I think their color shift paint would be cool for that. I've tried the Turbo Dork stuff, and I'm not sure if I like it or not. I only have the one paint that was given to me, but it's okay. I'm gonna do the same with some Starship Trooper bugs you have. That'd be cool. Some of those bugs are pretty big. Yeah, you might want to paint those up, man. So this is some Army Shade, or Army Painter Quick Shade Green Tone. Green Tone. And I'm going to use this on the stones that he's standing on. I've already put I also have to kit bash a Bug Queen together. I have her butt printed, but the front body messed up. Oh, that sucks. So I already put a wash of Agrax Earthshade on it, but I want some different colors. So I'm gonna try a little bit of green on here. Especially since it's over a really light gray paint. That still need a little more matte. Yeah, I'll use this. So I'm gonna use a little bit of chocolate brown and some dark sand. Okay, where are the vines here? Hey, we got three viewers tonight. Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching. Thanks for popping in. Thanks for spending your, well, two viewers now. Thanks for spending your precious time here on the stream. I appreciate it. Vine thing here. See, I'm doing them in brown. Normally I would do the vines in green, but I'm doing them in brown because eventually I'm going to put some snow on the base here. He's more of a, since we live here in Minnesota, you know, we're going to put some snow on the base. So these are going to be dead vines. Just barely see them. They're right in through here. Best one here is right there. Okay. So this is called beige or splitter muster light shade. But I think I want to use this on the ground. We already got the ground in brown. But I want to highlight it up differently than the vines. Especially since we have some other rocks here. Just go over them like so. Start with like that. Something simple. Alright, I'm going to hit it with this. This is called Deck Tan. It's more of a very light gray. I don't know why they call it Deck Tan, but they do. Use this just on the tops of the rocks here. Just like that. It's kind of a nice gray. Let's use this for his beard. Alright, got his beard all painted up. This guy is almost done. Thank you. I am going to do the snow using some Citadel Tentacle Paint, Valhalla Blizzard. That's how I will do that. As soon as I am done with getting all the painting done here. Inside of the shield here. I'm actually going to create wood lines. It's the, I'll show you. It's this stuff here. Citadel Technical, Valhalla and Blizzard. It's a texture paint, but they call it a technical paint. The texture paint, I know that there's other stuff out there, like Vallejo has texture paint. That's thicker. That's super thick. It still dries the same. I know that some of the technical paint here that Citadel sells, it's a little bit thinner. Of course, it comes in a much smaller bottle. Okay, we got the, I don't know if you can see it. Oh, right there. Now you can see the wood The inside of the shield there. Yeah, one's definitely more like a spackle type stuff. Great for using on bases and terrain and whatnot, but. So these stones that he's sitting on are actually part of a ruin, so they've got some designs sculpted into them, and I'm going to make them glow here a little bit. So I'm going to use a little bit of this kind of a bluish green paint from Reaper. I think it's a sample color that I've got. Looks like that. Find some of these. I'm just gonna paint right into that. Especially right there. take a little bit of the Army Painter Gray here. Where's my kind of beat up brush? There it is. Take my beat up little brush here. And just lightly going over the ruined pieces here. This little brush here. And we'll mix in a little bit of that desk tan, or deck tan, I guess I should say. Quick little outlines of some of these stones. Use the side of my brush here to go like that. This is polished bone from Reaper. I'm going to use this on the horn and the handle of his sword. And there's the horn on his belt, and his handle on his sword is done. It's got a little bit of this green left, so I think I'm going to thin this down just a little. This is that, green tone. It doesn't look very green anymore to me. It looks like there's some brown in it now. Glazing a little bit of color into his temple here. Right through there. Let me take a little bit of this. That's fresh blood. I'm going to use my shouldn't be this thick. And yet it is. So this is Reaper's clear red. And I just want to give him a little bit blush on his nose. This is literally just a glaze. We're not painting his nose red or anything. We're just glazing a little bit of red onto his nose. His cheeks are a little bit. Alright, what else can I do on this? Eyes. So for the eyes, we're using linen white. This is also a Reaper paint. Not a lot. Going back to my size 000 brush here. Brace our hands and just dot the eye. So. I'm gonna leave it alone. So, got the eyes painted in. Take some pure black here. This one I need a little bit of because I'll end up painting the base border with this. So again, thin it down here. I'm just going to go into the corner of the eye because we want him looking at his sword. Hopefully. That's not a good point. There, that's better. Yeah, I normally do as well. I just didn't on this guy for some reason. He says, I've always done the eyes first so I can make them partially close to the skin color of the face. Yes, and that's kind of what I was showing last night too, but I didn't do that on this guy. And I should have. Damn paint is not. Paint on the eyebrows. Yeah. Hey, leave HR out of this, man. I am HR. At least here, anyway. Actually, hold on, hold on. Kim is HR. She's upstairs. She doesn't know, man. It's fine. of solid black paint on the border here. Okay, I will call the painting on this guy done. Now we're just going to add in the snow. Get a scoop full of this here. So this is what the Valhalla Blizzard looks like. It's a technical paint. Yeah, I'm not even gonna use that much. I'm gonna use about half of that. So, and I think we'll put some down in here. They may have renamed it. You may be right. I always like to put a little bit on the character itself, so it looks like it snowed on them. Maybe not that much, though. Alright, there he is. There's my client's husband's character that he's been playing for 6 years. I do not know his name. But I'm going to take photos of him and send him to a client, and hopefully she will like it. Because I'm not doing it again. I'm not doing it again, you kind of make me. Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Poster tack off the base here. My normal rate, I charge $20 per hour with a 2-hour minimum. Now, she also had me illustrate a family portrait for them in fantasy comic book style. And I put in way more than 2 hours on this figure. So we're looking at right now... a little over $300. That's with the illustration and this. So yeah, I charge $20 an hour with a 2-hour minimum. Most of my stuff is just the 2-hour paint jobs. So like this is a 2-hour paint job. This is Proxima Midnight from Marvel Crisis Protocol. Pretty quick. I was going off of the comic book colors, so that was really easy. So yeah, this guy's all done. Woo-hoo. Pretty happy with that. The way he looks. Very barbarian-esque. You know, I kind of went through that too. I never had my wife or my family want me to sell stuff. Kim's always like, oh, you know, keep taking commissions and, you know, stuff like that. But I have so many minis right now that I don't have any more room. Like, the stuff that I paint here, the stuff that I have literally on my desk right now, I'm going to take to Con of the North probably and try and sell. Because hopefully somebody's going to want a warrior with a two-handed sword, or an elf fighter, or a ranger, or a female wizard or scribe, or I don't know, maybe they're looking for a townsfolk, so they're looking for a farmer, stuff like that. I'm not selling this though. Kim got me this. It's a little. It's a baby displacer beast chewing on its tentacle. So yeah, I'm gonna paint that up. And I probably won't sell this guy either, because this guy's just awesome. Love this bard. Sitting on luggage, just playing. But yeah, there's other stuff on here, like, this dude. Yeah, that displacer beast is just freaking adorable. So, but yeah, I've got a ton of stuff on here. I mean, I'm gonna even probably take some monsters and stuff and try and sell them, because hopefully somebody will want a monster or something. And yeah, because I have to clear out space on my shelves. I'm even gonna take these. I might take these. These are my what are they called? The Night's Watch. Brothers of the Night's Watch. That they painted up. Yeah, when I sell at cons, it's just based on time plus the cost of the model, yeah. And sometimes not even the cost of the model. Like, if I've had it for a while and it's just sitting on my shelf and I haven't used it at all, then I want to get it out of here. Especially if it's an older paint job. Like, if I've got a paint job that's been sitting on my shelves now for like 10 years and I haven't sold it, haven't used it, I'll put it on my sell rack for like 15 bucks or something like that. Just buy it and get it out of here. But some of these, like this guy here, I really want to keep him because I've painted him probably 3 times now. And every time that I've taken him to a con, somebody's bought him. I'm like, I like this one. So I shouldn't have just taken him to con. But this one I think I'm going to keep, which means I need to make space for him on my shelf. But yeah, some of these others, like, I'm falling down. Like, Kim bought me into the vampire level of the first Reaper Bones Kickstarter, and this is what I finally have left. I've almost painted all the rest of it. Finally. It's been like 10 years.
I still have, I've got a dragon to paint, I've got a fire giant to paint, I've got, what the heck is this,
I've got a Valkyrie to paint, I've got a ton of stuff. Oh, you sell on eBay, nice. Yeah, that's... I used to do that. I just wouldn't get the hits. I don't know if it was because people were underselling me, which is fine, but I just wasn't pleased with the eBay stuff. Oh, I've done BattleTech minis. I've painted a ton of 40K stuff. If you're ever on Facebook. Go to my Facebook page and you can see, you can go through all the albums that I had created. So yeah, there's a ton of 40K stuff. And yeah, in fact, I did a whole clan for a guy up in Canada for BattleTech. It's all in black and yellows. So yeah, I've painted a ton of different stuff. Fantasy, sci-fi, some horror stuff. I've even painted the occasional garden gnome for folks. I did a really cool project quite a few years ago now. They were about a foot to a foot and a half tall statues of Laurel and Hardy that I repainted for my next door neighbor's son. So that was cool. That was actually a lot of fun. I enjoyed that a lot. But yeah, we're running down here to the last couple of minutes. I think I'm gonna pop over to my channel here real quick. Where's the chat? There it is. Yes, the 40K folks are nuts. I agree. So yeah, quick shoutouts here. 01 Ella, Alessandra, Alien Gathering, another TV viewer, Commander Root, Drapsnat, Game Master's Vault. Thanks so much for sticking with me all night. I appreciate it. Hope you all have a wonderful rest of your evening. I'm off tomorrow. Hopefully I get to watch some of my other friends. I know most of those are bots. I still call them out because they are bots. Said that I had two people actually watching you and somebody else. And I don't know who that is. So if they're bots, whatever. I'd like to get more people actually watching. I know that there's a ton of people that go back and watch after the stream. Because they'll be like, you know, my wife will be like, oh, hey, you had 27 views on last night's stream. I'm like, oh, great, you know. Stupid Russian bots, yeah. That old Russia. That old mother of Russia. Feck off. That's where I'll go then. Yeah, I do post to YouTube after the stream. So you can go to my YouTube channel and watch it there. And, yeah. So. But thanks for watching, folks. I appreciate it. We'll catch you on Wednesday at 8 o'clock. So, take care and happy painting. Bye.